Welcome back, everyone, to some Saturday Chucking. Sorry, I'm recording this. I have about 45 minutes max to do this episode. I'm in Netherlands, Rotterdam, and we got another one to Felixstowe, which would be a nice little thing to do, in all honesty. Including since a lot of this stuff is not a great one to do. You know what? I'm going to do a Felixstowe because it's 4K for a quick trip, and I'm not heading to Kessel. What I haven't been looking at is time-wise, which is sort of important. This one's a simple job. We did it in, 10 minutes last time? And we're at 65K, so we're getting closer to the required amount for what's called getting a second driver in place. There we go. I'm like, I couldn't even see if it was green or not, so I stupidly parked way too far forward. That's one thing I don't like about, like, the foreign traffic lights. The United States has them on the opposite side of the road. Well, I might confuse some people in some situations. Generally, if it's opposite sides, not green, you don't have to go and you can actually see it from your car. I know it's different areas, different stuff kind of deal, but in this situation, it just makes the most sense that it would. Enter, what do you have? Freight market. Have the mission I want. Yep, take job. Fast delivery and fragile. It's 8 p.m. right now and should be a good drive. For post speed, what kind of load am I doing? Electronic pieces for post speed? Sorry, this seems more like a chemical company or a fertilizer kind of deal. Yeah, I know I did a horrible job doing this. I'm doing horrible at this, but I haven't played this in, 2-3 weeks? I recorded it all at once. There we go, that's what I want to see. Back to normal gears, time to give. We got 13 hours to deliver this. This route is 10 hours, jeez. Earliest I can, they want it between like 5 and 9:20. That sort of reminds me, like, I remember one company, there was like an accident on the road or something. Or was it that? There was some company that had a policy that you had to deliver it between like certain times. Some guy was fortunate enough to get there early, and the place he was going to put out a signal that you have to be there between those times because they were overfull at the time and they were trying to stop all the loads. And because of that, like, he ended up getting fired because he delivered his thing like 2 hours early. And it was all because, well, he wasn't talked to. Like, the person in charge of telling the truck drivers they have to be there between the time zones didn't pass along the news to every single driver heading to that destination. Ends up getting fired for that. And this is one of those stories that I saw from Quora, I think it's called. And it's an interesting story to share because, like, he was one of those people who you said worked at the company for years. And he was mad about it, but he decided to report the issue. He didn't go, like, just like, give up and say, I don't care, try to get a new job somewhere. He reported the problem, like, he didn't know about that kind of deal. Ends up going successfully, like, I think it went manager to manager to manager to manager.
Oh, really?
Yes. Really? 50 right here? Come on, let me speed up. It was 154. Sorry about that, but he went to his boss, who then went to his manager, it pretty much ended up going to, like, the district advisor, or whatever you want to call it, like the regional manager. And then the regional manager ended up calling like the main office, the CEO, the boss, whatever you want to say, and ends up getting like to verify all this information, get it all confirmed, because they couldn't make a decision because it was like corporate policy. something on this situation. And by the end of the day, it's just like he wasted pretty much the whole day just getting news to news to news to from different managers going up the ranks. Ends up, he finally successfully gets information back and he gets his job back. Or he gets his job back. He didn't lose anything, but maybe I think what? The day? And it was just one of those moments that he says one of those important things you gotta learn is sometimes patience will just help you out. That's one thing about one of those stories that I found interesting. So like, sometimes it's worth the deal to try to figure out why something happened and actually try to clear like a misunderstanding up like that instead of trying to deal, like just say, give up on it. Because that's the kind of situation that like you get fired because you delivered early. That's a problem, but if you're not the one at fault, it's one of those stories that say, well, that's painful to look back on, and you did nothing about it when you could have explained why you were early. But we're heading to Felixstowe. We're leaving. What city was this again? Yeah, whatever. I think we're going on a ferry. Is this the... Yeah, this is the right one. That person walked in. So I could have went that way. It's not like it would have mattered. Woo, that was close. Almost hit it. Harwich. Oh. I'm heading to Harwich. I'm about 90. I really hope it's the right one. Yeah, I believe so. But for a 5K drive, this ain't bad. Okay, I think it's... Ooh, cop. I got time. Yep. I wonder if it's true or not. Like, all things have, like, the no turn on, like, colors deal. Like, red or whatever. Because I know the United States, like, you can turn right on green. No big problems. So it makes me wonder... If it's true, like, that you can't do it, like, in, like, what's it called? In, like, Spain, France, and all that stuff. And England. It's one of those things that... Great Britain, England, whatever one called. Ooh, jeez. It's one of those things that I never knew about, but when I was in Germany, I was wondering why no one's turning right. I figured out my tour guide told me, because he was driving, it's just like... You're not allowed to. It's just one of those weird rules that I never understood. I can understand some situations when you don't want to do it. Because let's be honest, there's a lot of idiots on the road. But then other situations, it's pointless. And I have seen situations that just make me want to facepalm. Because people in the United States, waiting for the light to change when they have right away and everything like that. Sorry, give me a sec. Oh, my truck is still damaged. About 1 hour left, and we got 4 hours to turn in, and it's an hour till later. That's fine. I need to slow down, because I am following a cop. Why is my speed limit 80 and the cop is way up there? Nope, I see that. I'm not falling for that crap. You gonna drop speed limit on me? Really? Come on. I'm trying to see. I need to get closer. I think I'm going straight and that's doing a turn off. Yeah, Felixstowe is straight. Sorry if I mispronounced that. It's just one of those things. Wow, this is still a 10-minute drive. I didn't expect that. Yeah. Yeah, go. Come on. Oh, nice, 97 miles per hour or kilometers per hour. Nice little drive though. Well, you can see the end result there. Well, I have to get off at the next exit, so I need to do this. Oh, quick saved. Getting off at this exit. 30-minute drive for 30 kilometers. Sorry, I could not read that sign at all. There we go. Yeah, I always slow down too much. Yeah, it's probably a good thing that I'm going this slow. I'll probably get a ticket otherwise. Because I think the speed limit drops probably shortly. Oh, going too fast. When's the speed going to drop? I'm waiting for it. I think. Oh, someone. Sakatsuki has dropped off a load. Yeah, at least we're at Felixstowe now. It's a 15-minute drive. I did not expect that. I thought it was shorter last time. Yeah, happens. I do plan to try to make all my videos 30 minutes, but I know this week I have two that aren't. Sorry about that, but that just happens. Nope. There we go. Okay, are we around this corner yet? Trade annex. Let's see. Probably should set this up so I don't have to keep doing this. It's not as difficult as like the American one is. Okay, come on, do the roundabout. Yeah. I'm blocking the street. Don't care. Come on. Oh, are you serious right now? Dang it, I screwed that up so much. Oh, are you serious right now? You know what, I'm really tempted to just say screw it, because this is starting to annoy me. There, that looks good. There it goes, jeez. That was hard. Any short jobs? Not really, no short jobs, really. Anything really good? Not really. Bang. That's the quickest one. How much time do I have? Okay, yeah, I can do this. Yeah, I do. I think I'm gonna call it here because I don't have much time and I still need to get ready. But thanks for watching, everyone. I'm sorry about this short video for the day, but I've been busy this week and just can't do it much. Hopefully, though, we get enough money shortly so we can actually get a new truck going. How much money do I have? 72k, so hopefully we can get that going and working soon. With that, thanks for watching, everyone. I hope everyone has a good day. And just doing a quick save. With that, goodbye for now.